All right. Trees stand in the sun for the benefit of man. Who stand? Trees stand. So right there you have subject and verb in the first two words itself. Subject and verb. So how do you say trees? That is what case? First case? Plural you get, you have to put, right? Because trees stand, that is object. First case, plural. And what you have? If you use some other word for trees and all, you could use, it will be plural. Taru. Taru also means tree, but you have not gotten that yet. But there might be some smart student in the class who jump in ahead. Vrikshaha. What they do? They stand. How do you say stand? Tishtanti. Tishtanti. Right. That is what number one person? That third person? Plural. Tishtanti. Trees stand. All right. Where they stand? In the sun. I gave word for sun already. Surya, yeah? Surya is sun. Ravi is also sun. Bhanu is sun. Arka is sun. What kind of sun? Bhaskara is sun. You name it. We have many words for sun. In English, how many words for sun? Surya Bhagavan has 1,008 names. What to talk about one? Bhanu. Right, anyway. So, Surya. That is one ending in A. So that's easiest for you. Right? They stand in the sun. That will be? Seventh case. Yes. Seventh case singular of Surya will be what? Surya. Surya. Trees stand in the sun. Then now? No, Ravi, you don't know how to decline that because I haven't given it in class yet. That is ending in E. And we haven't done yet. How you'll decline? Any you did it? What you put? Where? If you use Ravi? No, that will be Ravau. See, you have not gotten that yet. That will confuse you. Ravi will be declining Hari. There's a what? One fellow told me last week, book to learn Sanskrit in 30 days. He said he had that for 30 years now. Really? He said, I have that book for 30 years. And it's still That proves that you have to be in the class. And only in this class, I tell you. Really? Sat Maharaj was telling me he brought a Sanskrit teacher from India. He brought a Sanskrit teacher from India. After a little while, no student will come back. He's after me brought a teacher. Because the teaching method for Western people is a totally different thing. All right. So, trees stand in the sun, and now for the benefit of man. Eh? But there's Google. For man. Naraya. That good enough. Naraya. For man. So if you put that is a good, a solid attempt. So that will be, for the words which you know already, I have not given you that before, but this artha word, artha, is added next to words to mean for the benefit of whatever word it is added to. Artha. So what is actually here is nara plus artha, like that. That artha is used in Sanskrit for the benefit of. I thought somehow earlier I'd go and research and find it. But nobody are gonna do. Hitaya. Huh? Hitaya. That also, correct. Hitaya. It's longer. Hitaya. So that means research was done. Hitaya. What? Huh? Nara krama. Krama, not used in that sense. Hitaya or artha. Hitaya is a very good replacement. Nara hitaya, you'll have to put one word, right? For the benefit. Eh? I can't hear you. Krite. Nara krite. Used, but not as frequent as these two. Artha and hitaya. Narakriti.
If it didn't join the word, it is a narasya, 6 feet off. Will that be okay or you have to join?
You have to join it. Yeah. So, in Sanskrit, when you don't join words, that also is good. When you don't join words, you must make sure that the words are declined. So, like here. Now see nara. You can't have nara in a sentence just like that. This word is not declined. Isn't it? That has to be in one of the 24 forms. The only form you'll find is 8K singular. But then it will not apply there. Hey, nara. What? Trees stand in the sun, hey, nara, artha. What is that? So, the word has to be declined. If you want to avoid the declension, you have to join the word with some other word. But the last word will have to be declined. If you join a few words, the last one now will have to be declined. So, that is one thing. Second thing is, now, how come artha is not declined here? Because artha is an indeclinable also. Call an indeclinable. So you are saved. Artha can be declined also. Eh? There are many words in Sanskrit which appear in declinable form and indeclinable form. Right. Next one now. Indra and Agni sit in the boat on the lake. Wow. Indra and Agni sit in the boat. So the verb is sit. Who sit? Uh-huh. Indraha cha Agnihi cha. Or you could put one cha, it doesn't matter, right? One cha is enough. And you could put a cha anywhere. So if you join up this now, the two words, you can do that also in many. That's how you get long, long words in Sanskrit, you know. Most words in Sanskrit is about this length only. How long is that? That's about the longest word in Sanskrit. Very short, short words. Then what happened? There's something called Sandhi. Then you join up all of these words. Then you get one, whole line is one word. In Gita and all, you see sometimes. A whole line, one word. That's because you join up at all little words like that. So now, Indraha cha Agnihi cha. Indra and Agni. What they do? They sit. Eh? See that aha. You get that, right? I gave that. See that. Two of them, because dual. That is third person. Dual. Third person, dual. Okay. Yes? Not necessary. I told you just now. You could have one, you could have two. You could remove both of them also and make a compound. No chai required. Huh? What? You could, yeah, make it like that if you want. Or you decline Agni only. Hari? Hari? Harayaha. So Indra Agni. In place of this whole thing here, you can even find any one of those. And then you don't have any cha. This is Indra Agni, right? And since it is dual, the Agni is declined. Agni in dual case Agni. And this is Agni Indra. Indra in dual case is Indrav. Like Ramav. Right. So Indra cha Agni cha Sidataha. Both of them sit. Now where they sit? In the boat. In the boat? What boat? What word do you use for boat? Huh? Jalayana. Nobody get a boat word? Eh? Nauka. Nauka is the easiest word. Then what? Nauka in which case you want? Seven case? Singular. What it will be? Yes. That will be Naukayam. You have to do a little research also, no? Naukayam. I only give Rama so far and Phala, isn't it? Yes. Feminine noun I never give. Yes, no, when I finish this, I give. Yes, no. Indra and Agni sit in the boat. Right? Now, on the lake. Which one? Kasara. Kasare. Or Sarah only? Sarvovada, yeah, Sarvovade. Yeah, so many words for lake. Easy. So you just have to get whichever word you use and put it in which case? Seven case. Now, how do you know Indra and Agni are sitting on the lake, in the lake, on the boat? Just by context and all, you know. They're not sitting on the lake. They can't sit on the lake. The boat could sit on the lake, but they can't sit on the lake. Yeah? It's a dry lake, but I know a lake by land. Yes. On the boat or on the lake? Both. Right. Girls go to school to study. Balaha. Or balikaha also you can say. Balaha, balikaha. Balika or bala is girls. No, they go to school. So go, they go, third person, plural. What you'll get? What? Some people are not saying anything. Correct. If you have it by itself, if you have this by itself, without an English sentence, you could translate both ways. You don't have to worry, you'll get it correct. You could translate it both ways. Now we have an English sentence here, we know that we are making like that, right? That's why I said, just now said balikaha, so that you could distinguish. But this is also absolutely fine. Right. Balikaha or balaha gachanti, the girls go. See, this will not happen in Hindi. Why it will not happen in Hindi? The verb also will become feminized. In Sanskrit, the verbs remain same. In Hindi, feminine verb for feminine, masculine verb for masculine. Verb also take different form. English? Like Sanskrit? Yeah. English is like Sanskrit, isn't it? Gender doesn't affect verb. He, she, or it goes. Doesn't affect species also. He, she, or it goes. The man goes, the woman goes, the bull goes, the dog goes, the turtle goes, all of them go. Same go. Man goes, the turtle goes. Okay. Now, where they go? To school. Vidyalayam. Vidyalayam or schoolam? You put vidyalayam is fine. Vidyalayam. Schoolam. Layam. Pachalam. Pathshalam, it will be. To school. Okay. The girls go to school. To study. To study is? What? But there, to study, right? Here, that day you want a noun. What do you want? Patitum, if you take the verb. The go is the verb. The student has two verbs. For the purpose of study. For the, to study. So then how you say? Just like what? No, if you said you use a verb now, to study, then what you put? Nothing. No, we are making very simple sentence now. You have to just take it in there. We are making sentences with a subject and a verb. All the other things in the middle, you will have to put in some form. So, then that means we have two sentences. Even if you say, girls go to study. No. So in English, you have to study, there is what? What form of verb? There is no form of any verb. To study is a form of a verb. So that's what I'm saying. This is like a verbal root. Yeah. No, but that's not a form of the verb. Like, they go, I go, you go, he, she, it goes, like that. Verbal noun. Right. That's an extension.
Yes.
That's why I told you, for the purpose of study. In Sanskrit, when you see that, that is for the purpose, that's why it says patitum. So anyway, so you can put there now several alternatives. All of these words. Adhyayana. Adhyayana means study. Study, study. So then, adhyayanartha, adhyayanaya, patitum. What will be what? No, so just now I told, so when you read it, that is for the purpose of study. You will have to get whichever case that applies there. Yeah. Right, next one now. Men draw water from the well for the king. Draw means like draw with a bucket, not like draw with a pen. They draw water. So men is the subject. How do you say? Naraha. Okay. What they do? Draw what you did not get? Karshanti. Krish becomes? Like that. Karshanti, to draw. Krish karsh, to draw. To draw. That is the root from which Krishna's name is formed. Prahanti. Yeah, you're going a roundabout way to find it. Yeah, it's okay. But the problem when you do that, right? Prahanti can mean many other things than draw. So the actual root is? Yeah. It could mean, it will mean that, but it will mean many other things. To draw. How Krishna's name is formed from that? Krish Karshati, to draw. To attract, yeah. That's how his name is formed. Okay, so men draw. What they draw? Water. Water will be, in which case now? Jalam. They draw water. Water in singular? Water in singular. They draw water. Simple. Jalam in second case. Then, from the well for the king. Well is? Kupa. So when you want kupa, in which case now? Not seventh case. Fifth case. Fifth case of kupa will be? Upat. Which one? Masculine. Proper masculine. Then? For the king. Which case you want? Fourth case. Yeah, you got it. Just using all these simple cases which you have done already. If you're catching the hang of this, then you're catching it, eh? If you haven't caught the hang of this, you're in some trouble, eh? You have to go and do some push-ups. Why This is the very heart of Sanskrit. You should do this and catch this clear in your head. The other thing you will just add here and there. Right. Now next. Oh, Dongle. The bullock draws the cart with the farmer. The bullock tied the farmer to the cart. One fellow riding the horse. And he fall off. He telling his friend, he say, man, I was riding my horse. And I fall off the horse and I broke my leg. And the horse pick me up and bring me home and call a doctor. This fellow say, what, you have a smart horse, boy? He say, no, you stupid, he call a horse doctor. Anyway, you know the meaning there. Don't take any other meaning there. I mean, you could take several meanings there. But take the meaning which comes out first. So the subject is the bullock. And bullock in Sanskrit is Vrishabha. Like Rama only. Vrishabha. Vrishabha. And then which case you want? The bullock. When we used to learn in that West Indian reader thing, they used to write ox. And eh? Ox. So oxaha. Ox, ox. I always wonder what is that ox? Because in the village everybody saying bull, 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 isn't it? Everybody says bull. And I never see an ox. For years I wanted to see an ox. Okay, Vrishabha draws the cart. Draws will be the same. So now you want which number and person? Which number and case? A person here. Third person? One, yeah. Vrishabha karshati, the bull, the ox, draws. Now we have to say draws the cart with the farmer. So he draws the cart. So what is the Sanskrit word for cart? Ratha. Ratha is chariot. You were there. Nobody here was in my Bhagavatam class. There's one Shakatasur. Shakatasur. Shakata. Shakatam. So, draws the cart. That is called Shakatam. Shakatam. Draws the cart. That Shakatasur came and embodied that cart or something. Yeah. Now you have to remember what is cart in Sanskrit by remembering Shakatasur. You have to remember Asura. Rakshasa to remember Sanskrit. Shakatasur. Very famous. in Bhagavatam. Krishna was sleeping under the cart. He tried to kill him. He gave him one kick and threw him over there, and the cart broke to pieces. Okay, then with the farmer, Krishi Gaurakshava Nijyam. Farmer is? The? Krishikaha or Krishika. Krishika. Right? Like Rama only. Krishika. So now which case you want? Third case. So then it will be? Krishikena.
Like that. That or then no. Krishikena.
Krishikena. So now what other reading you could get with that? Vrishavaha. In Sanskrit, you could only get a meaning. In English, you could get some other meaning maybe. In Sanskrit also, I suppose. What meaning will come, you know? This is bull and this is cart. I tie the farmer between the two and drag the cart. You drag the cart with the farmer. But of course, nobody will suggest nothing. No. So that is true. So the instrumental case, please remember, the instrumental case is not used only in one sense. So same with fifth, same with sixth, and this third. Those cases, they are not restricted merely to that name which you call the instrumental. And when we get to the genitive case, the sixth case especially, you will say, it is possessive, but there are many, many times when that sixth case also is used and has nothing to do with possession. The cases are like that. Now, what you are saying, right? If you ask the other question, and this is a good question actually, because this is where you get the concept of Sanskrit. If you have to say this in the sentence, which other form of the eight forms, you will have a choice? If you don't use the third case, which other way you will get to say? But the English sentence says, the bullock draws the cart. Right? So then if you say in the cart, you'll have to put seven case. So then you'll have to translate the sentence as the bullock draws the cart for the purpose of, or for the benefit of, or due to the farmer. But then that is not the English sentence. Yes. Yeah. So the other way to ask the question is, which other case do I have a choice? Without changing the English sentence. And I had mentioned before also, when we say instrumental, or we say dative, or we say ablative, or genitive, and we give some English usages of that, please don't feel that this is restricted to that. It is, the usages of the cases are very broad in Sanskrit, because they have to cover so many things. which is to be found in English. I don't know if in English you have such things. Let us just analyze a little bit. The man will be subject, right? Brings will be verb. So then you have water and you have to the bull. So you will think that here, to the bull will be in what case? Fourth case. And water will be in? Because that is what he brings. But some of these verbs are such, right? I remember I told you that verbs of movement and going and all that kind of thing, right? They will govern second case. These type of sentences in Sanskrit, they have what they call as a double object. Double object means that these two words will be in second case. So you, when you're translating, you will have to actually say, well, he brought the bull to the water, he brought the water to the bull. So what I'm saying is, when we give a case, second case, for example, we say is used as the object, right? Or fourth case is an indirect object, to the bull here. There are other rules in Sanskrit which now will tell, no, you will have to put both of them in second case. You will have, the rules are there, like that. So they are not restricted exactly to fourth case or restricted exactly to second case and all that kind of, because there are so many other things. All right. Now next one. Parvati goes with Shiva to the mountain for tapas. You see, I could have put that to do tapas, then verb will have come in. To do tapas. Just like the sentence before. So who goes? Parvati? Parvati. Parvati or Parvati? Parvati. Anybody looked? She goes. Goes? Gachati. Parvati goes. Then, with Shiva, that will be Shivena Saha. I told you also this Saha one at one time, na? Saha, I told you? Shivena Saha. Shivena Saha, yeah. No. Which Ra? I know Ra. Dasha. Shiva, Shiva. Shivena Saha. And then? For tapas. Or to the mountain. Oh, we have several things there yet. To the mountain.
Parvatam.
Parvatam Gachati. She goes to the mountain with Shiva. And now you still have to put one more word inside it. For? Tapasaha? Tapaya is the easy thing for you to put. Tapaya, yes. That, because of what you did in class already, that's the easiest route for you to take. Yes. Yeah, this comes from the E I had put there before, sorry. Correct. That remnants of the E. Right. Tapaya will be easiest thing for you. If you have to get that in fourth case from tapas, that will be tapas, eh? That you have not declined, right? That is advanced.
More advanced. Tapaya.
Tapaha. Tapaya. So, that could mean also to burn. She went there with Lord Shiva to burn, because tapa means to burn. Right. Brihaspati.
I hope we have time still there.
Oh, I can't give you no feminine today. Brihaspati is the guru of the gods. Oh, oh, oh. Brihaspati hi asti. Brihaspati hi asti. He is. Brihaspati is. Of the gods? Devanam. You want plural. Six case? Brihaspati, Devanam. Kurum. In English, that he is object. Kurum, Second case. In Sanskrit, we say Guruhu. Devanam Guruhu. Devanam Guruhu. The Guru of the gods. I'll tell you why just now. This will have to be said in Sanskrit like this, because Brihaspati and or Guru, whichever one you say, can be an adjective of the other. And the adjective has to follow the noun. So it has to be exactly the same case and number and everything as the norm. So Brihaspati Devanam Guruhu Asti. He is the guru of the Devas. This is said like this in Sanskrit. In English, I don't know how all you English teachers will know how you say that and all. I mean, this thing here is the guru or the guru in Sanskrit. I mean, English, people in English. See, Brihaspati is. That is the sentence, right? In English. Brihaspati is. The guru in English is what case there? You have to put an accusative. Yeah. Well, you'd put in your language. Yes. Rama kills Taraka and Subahu, but not. He saved Marich. Ramaha. Taraka and Subahu. This will be Tarakam. Kills. What do you use? Han. Yeah. Anybody use anything else?
Barayati.
Huh? Barayati. Oh, Marayati. Marayati. Which conjugation it comes in? You know. No, if it comes in tense, not causal. No, if it comes, see if it comes in 10 conjugation. Bahuncha. Hanti. He kills, that is not plural, eh? That will fool you. He kills. Tarakam, Subahum, Cha. He kills Taraka and Subahum. Then? Not? Huh? Atra, na? Why you put Atra? Eh? The? Parantu. Yes. Parantu is but. No, Atra means here. Tu alone also, you can put. Parantu or tu. Or you say, natu, like that. Who is the next one? Marich. Marichaha. Maricham. Natu maricham. Or... here, parantu, na, correct spelling of maricham? Anybody checked? Yes? No, not here anymore. No, you always have to put it, this extension, as she will call it. You have to put that extension after the verb. Yeah. You can't put it on the inside of it. And that is one more thing about Sanskrit. That is why many of the Sanskrit verses and all of that have more than one meaning, because the language is like that. The other clue you will have this tu or this parantu. Whenever you see that, you know some change has taken place. Tu or parantu. So you'll have to look out for that. Then next one. Ravana takes Lanka from Kubera. Ravanaha takes Harati. Harati is best. That's simple. Or Harati or Upaharati. Lanka. Will be Lankam. Then from Kubera. That will be from I don't know if it's Kuver or Kuber. We keep saying Kuber. Anybody check? Kuver or Kuber? Kuber? Okay. Then? This is fifth case.
I know. I don't find it can be used interchangeably, but is there a specific context or time that it can be?
No. I'll tell you it like this. That rule, it is more often that in place of a fifth case, a third case is used. Rather than in place of a third case, a fifth case is used. You get what I said? One is used a little bit more often than the other. Instead of a fifth case, you could use a third case very comfortably. But the other one is not so often like this way. Birds sing in the morning.
Out of joy.
Who sing? And what they do? Dayanti. Birds sing. In the morning. Correcto. Prata kale. Prata kale patheryastu. Out of joy. Out of joy will be? But that is with joy. That is okay also. Out of joy will be fifth case. Sukhat. Or Anandat. Sukhat. Anandat or Sukhat. Okay, our next two classes today I can do. I have some important work that I have to go and attend to.